All right, so I'd like to make a frequency distribution from the heart rate data I had put in Minitab Express and put in order. So the first thing I need to do for a frequency distribution is I need to find the class width. So the class width for a frequency distribution is the highest value minus the lowest divided by the number of classes that you want. All right, so for this problem, I'm going to use six classes. It's a good idea to choose the number of classes to be between 5 and 20. Anything more than 20, you wouldn't really get a good idea how many data points fall in each class, and any fewer than 5, you would have all of the data falling in just a few bars, so you would not get a good sense of the overall shape of the data. So my data set had 98 as the highest value and 62 as the lowest value. I'm going to divide that by 6. And that turns out to be 36 divided by 6, which is 6. So this will be the class width. The class width is the difference between two consecutive lower class limits and two consecutive upper class limits. Now, if this value did not turn out to be a whole number, it's a good idea to round up regardless of what is after the decimal point. Round up to the nearest whole number. So, for example, if this came out to be 6.3, I would round up to 7 and use 7 as the class width. Okay, so there's a few ways you can start your frequency distribution. Okay, so remember we'll have a column for the classes and a column for the frequencies. Okay. So, to start the first lower class limit, you want to take a look at your minimum value. The minimum value for this data set was 62. Now, I could go a few units down the minimum value and start from there, and that's perfectly fine. Or you could start at the minimum value, which is what I'm going to do. So, I'm going to start at 62. Now, remember the class width is the difference between two consecutive lower class limits. So I'm not going to be adding 6 to 62 and going this way. I'm going to be adding 6 to 62 and going down. So 68 will be my second class limit, and then 74, and then 80, and then 86, and then 92. So I'll have 6 lower class limits. And then I want to create the upper class limits. Now, for frequency distributions, the classes need to be mutually exclusive, meaning that there shouldn't be any overlap between classes. So if this second class starts at 68, that means the first class should stop at 67. So if the third class starts at 74, then the second class should end at 73. And notice the difference between these two consecutive upper class limits is 6. Okay, so continuing on. There I have my 6 classes, all mutually exclusive, and all of them have a class width of 6. Now, for the frequencies, I just need to count how many values fall into the classes. So my first class was from 62 to 67. So I would just look at my data set, and it is helpful when the data set is put in order. And just for the sake of brevity, I counted how many values, oops, pardon me, that's my cat, how many values fell in that class. So I had I had 3 values in that first class. And looking at my data set put in order, I had 6 values in my second class, and then 12, and then 22, and then 4, and then the last class had 3 values. Now, one thing that's going to affect the frequencies would be if you would change the number of classes. So if you would change the number of classes, these counts could possibly change. However, what won't change is the fact that if I added up the number of frequencies, if I added up this column, I should get 50, which was my sample size. All right, so this right here is a basic frequency distribution, and from this information, we could go ahead and do some other things like construct a histogram.